all my niggas on the east side. Throw up your guns, all my niggas from the west side. Throw up your guns, all my niggas from the east side. Yeah, nigga. My niggas crooked though it seems. My every single thought is quarter peak collecting cream. I'm made, nigga. Picture me dying in the blaze. A gunfire will not retire till I'm paid. Turn up base of pie. Won't be fly, we fly by. Bitches throw me kisses. Niggas who come in the Brooklyn.
Dustin Poirier, Conor McGregor, two of the most exciting fighters in the world of mixed martial arts, will collide for a third time tomorrow night. Each fighter having a dominating win over the other, the rubber match will decide who indeed is the better fighter of the two. Now, both fighters have incredible stand-up and their boxing is actually considered one of the best for both fighters. Dustin being the bigger man and having the momentum from the previous fight, he has the advantage. Now, let's talk about what went wrong for Conor in the second fight, because we all saw that he went from this karate style where he was very, very well balanced to a much more boxing stance where he was a lot heavier on his front foot and everything went wrong for him. So what happened? So we all know Conor originally had a fight agreement with Manny Pacquiao in Dubai and he was focused on that fight. Conor was in Dubai training boxing and he only had his boxing coach with him. He had no MMA training coach. He had no kickboxing partners with him. And we all saw that he went from a karate stance to a much more conventional boxing stance. Dustin noticed this and he destroyed Conor's legs with his kicks. He was picking his legs apart, and Conor McGregor being in such a heavy stance, in a boxing stance like he is right here, he's so heavy on his feet that he doesn't have enough time to lift his feet and get him out of the way. That's where he would have benefited from that karate stance. Now, Dustin is the much better wrestler, and McGregor, in my opinion, is slightly the better striker. I'm picking Dustin to win because he has the momentum and nothing to lose. I think he will try to make the fight rough and ugly, wearing down Conor as the rounds go by. And we all know Conor McGregor doesn't exactly have the greatest gas tank. Conor telling Dustin, first one to go for the takedown is a bitch, tells me he's coming to take Dustin out. I honestly think Dustin should try and bully Conor, take him down, tire him out, and finish him late. Now, what I think Conor should do to win is stay in front of Dustin. Go ahead and bang with him, trade shots, and land those kicks. He did have some success in the first fight before those leg kicks and his cardiovascular system started failing him. So he just needs to come in shape and he'll be okay. Now, for my final thoughts, I think Dustin Poirier is going to win this fight. I think he's going to do it by late submission. I don't feel like he's going to trade and bang with Conor. He might. He does have the skills to keep up with him, but I don't see him doing it. I think he's going to go and try to make it rough and ugly, go ahead and tire him out, and then probably like in the fourth or in the fifth, he's going to take him down. And then he's gonna submit Conor McGregor. So let me know what you guys think. Comment below, like, share, please subscribe, and thank you for watching.